Hello chess friends, welcome to the channel. Today's game is Alexander Grischuk against Hikaru Nakamura, second game of the semifinals of the Fide Grand Prix 2019 in Moscow. The first game between Nakamura and Grischuk, with Nakamura with the white pieces, ended in a draw. Nakamura played the Giuoco Piano, but instead of going for the classic knight maneuver, he tried to conquer some space on the queenside to open the A-file, but he didn't achieve much, and the game ended in a draw after 35 moves. Today's game was sharper, more complex, and both players had also to play against the clock. Let's get started. Grischuk with the white pieces opens with d4, and Nakamura answers with knight to f6, c4, e6, knight to f3, and d5, g3, opening the fiancetto, bishop to e7, and bishop to g2. This is the Catalan. Short castle for black, short castle for white, and d capture on c4. The queen moves to c2, attacking the pawn, and here comes b5, protecting c4. After a4, Nakamura continues with the best move, that is b4. Let's go back one move. What are the alternatives? Of course, not a6, because after a captures, the a pawn can't recapture because he's pinned to the rook. Also, c6 is not so good, because after a captures on b5 and c captures on b5, knight to g5, there is the bishop discovered attack against the rook. So also this c6 move doesn't give anything to black. Not only that, but white is better. So, going back to our game, after a4, Nakamura continues with b4. Knight in f goes to d2, not only attacking the pawn, but also opening the bishop attack against the rook, but the c-pawn is still on c7, and so here comes c6. Knight captures on c4, queen captures on c4, and rook to d1 attacking the queen. The queen moves to c5, this is a theoretical line with more than 40 games in database. Bishop to e3, attacking the queen, and the queen moves to h5. Knight in b goes to d2. Grischuk never played this position, but Nakamura, yes. He played two recent games, two draws against Ding and Vachelagrav. Here comes knight to g4, not only attacking the bishop, but also with the terrible threat queen captures on h2. So here comes knight to f3, protecting h2, and knight captures on e3. After the knight recaptures, the game is equal. Black is a pawn up, but is quite behind in development. But at least Nakamura was able to take away from white the bishop pair. a5 now. Knight to d4. With this move, Grischuk deviates from the Ding Nakamura, where Ding played knight to c4. Anyway, both moves are good. Bishop to a6, rook in a goes to c1. We notice that this c6 pawn is under pressure, and here comes rook to c8. Bishop to f3, watching e2 and attacking the queen, and Nakamura moves the queen to g6, trying to change the queens. If the queens are exchanged, the game really is completely equal and white didn't gain nothing. Bishop to e4, again queen to h5, and again bishop to f3, repeating the moves. Queen to g6, bishop to e4, but after queen to h5, here comes king to g2 with Grischuk that stops the repetitions. The game is completely original. Rook to a7, h4 now. g6, this is a good move, not only controlling f5, but also clearing the g7 square that could be useful for the queen to go back to the center of the board. f4, queen to h6, knight to b3, and king to h8, bishop to d3, and bishop to b7. Changing the bishop on d3, or leaving the bishop on a6, and letting white changing the bishop, is okay for black. Probably better than moving the bishop to b7, is better to improve the queen's position, bringing the queen to f8. After bishop to b7, here comes knight to c4. c5 with the discovery check. bishop to e4, and again, changing the bishop is okay, but Nakamura doesn't want to lose this light square bishop. Bishop to a6. But after knight in b captures on a5, or also another good move was knight to d6, white starts to be better. Queen to f8, bishop to f3, and rook to d8. A really complex position, also a time-consuming one. In fact, Nakamura only has 8 minutes on the clock, while Grischuk 9 minutes and a half for the next 10 moves. Here comes h5, not a bad move at all. Stockfish suggests that it's better to keep improving the position with b3 and later with knight on e5. Anyway, Nakamura continues with bishop to f6, a good move, but still in this position, Stockfish has some different ideas. Instead of bishop to f6, he likes to play g5, because with g5, black wants to weaken the structure in front of white king. A weaker king will make white initiative a bit weaker. After g5, f5, bishop to c8, the light square bishop will move to e4 or g4, at the next move, rook to a6, white is still better, but there is a lot more to think and to play. Let's go back to our game. After bishop to a6, rook captures on d8, queen recaptures on d8, and rook to d1 against the queen. Let's go back one move. Let's watch another idea. What happens if h captures on g6? In this position, the best recapture is with the h pawn, much better than recapturing with the f pawn, to maintain a solid structure. After rook to h1 we check, king to g8, and here comes e4. Bishop captures on c4, because this bishop was really a bad piece. The knight recaptures, knight to c6, and here comes e5. At first, knight to d4 against the queen. Queen to d3, knight captures on f3, queen recaptures, bishop back to e7, and this idea didn't give anything special to white. So, going back to our game, we said after the queen recapture to d8, Grischuk continues with rook to d1 against the queen. Rook to d7, the best answer. Rook captures. Knight recaptures a little bit better than queen capture, because with this recapture, Nakamura improves the knight's position. And here comes h6, restricting the king. In this position, the best move is king to g8 to bring the king more toward the center, but also protecting the important f7 square. Nakamura continues with knight to b6, and this is a mistake. Here comes knight to e5 with tempo, because the knight is threatening the winning fork, knight captures on f7. In this position, bishop captures on e5, knight to c6 first, knight to c4 against the white queen with the idea of the knight fork. There were many possible solutions after this move, but knight to c4 is one of the good ones. Knight captures queen on d8, knight to e3 we check, king to f2, much better to bring the king toward the center, and knight captures on c2. But here comes knight captures on f7 we check, king to g8, and after knight captures on e5, Grischuk is winning. He is a pawn up with a better pawn structure. Nakamura plays where he is stronger. c4, a good move. Bishop to g4, attacking the weak pawn, and knight back to d4, protecting the pawn. King to e1, king to f8, king to d1, the king moves toward the queen side, and here comes king to e7, and this is a mistake. Grischuk continues with e3 first against the knight. The knight moves to b3. In this position, white plays a good move, that is knight to c6 we check, king to f6, and knight captures on b4 against the bishop. Let's go back some moves. It seems that after knight to b3, knight captures on g6 we check is even stronger, because of course the pawn can't capture the knight, or the h pawn will promote to queen. So king to f6 is the best answer. The knight will move back to e5. There is another weakness in black structure, and this initiative on the queen side is well protected also by the king. Let's go back to the game. We said after knight captures on b4, attacking the bishop moves to b7. Here comes bishop to e2, knight to a5, protecting the pawn, and king to d2. Knight to b3, we check. King to c3. Knight to c5, attacking a4. So here comes a5. Knight to e4, we check. That is a fork against the g pawn, but the king captures on c4, and Grischuk is really strong on the queen side. Knight captures on g3, attacking the bishop. Bishop to d3, and here comes g5. But after f captures on g5, we check. Nakamura resigns. Let's make some moves. The king must recapture on g5. Here comes a6, attacking the bishop. The bishop will probably move to a8. Here, bishop captures on a7, and king captures on h6. But bishop to g8 is a great idea, because if the pawn advances, or even if the pawn doesn't advance, this pawn is lost and the bishop can freely move on this diagonal. After e5, there is bishop to d5, supported by the knight and the king. This bishop will be e-changed, and the a-pawn will promote to queen, winning the game. So after some days of good chess, today we had a really beautiful game between two titans of the sport. I really like this game, and of course I hope that you enjoyed it too. Grischuk is the first player to reach the finale. Tomorrow there is the tie break between Nepomniachtchi and Wojtaszek. And finally, the Fide Grand Prix 2019 in Moscow is exciting again. Today's game is over. Thank you very much for watching, and see you tomorrow. Goodbye.